Hello everyone, how's it going? You know, hypothyroidism is a lot more common in the United States than hyperthyroidism. However, hyperthyroidism is actually a condition that is important to seek treatment for as well, because if it's left untreated, it actually can lead to other health conditions that may actually surprise you. So today we're going to learn a little bit more about what can cause this condition and what some of the symptoms may be. If that sounds interesting to you, then keep watching. Now, hyperthyroidism is a condition where the thyroid gland actually produces too much of the thyroid hormone, which makes sense because sometimes you might think of someone who's hyper and they appear to have too much energy. But we can imagine the havoc that this could do to our bodies. Since the thyroid gland actually helps the body to regulate temperature, it also helps to control the heart rate and the metabolism. Now, let's talk about some of the symptoms. There are some symptoms that could easily be confused with other health conditions, but if you are dealing with hyperthyroidism, you may have one or more of these symptoms. You may have anxiety or irritability. You may have tremor in the hands or fingers, sensitivity to heat, weight loss, frequent bowel movements, changes in the menstrual cycle, thick red skin on the shins or the tops of the feet, rapid or irregular heartbeat, difficulty sleeping, may even have an enlarged thyroid gland, hair loss, or you may experience changes in your hair texture. You may have bulging eyes, muscle weakness, an increased appetite, and even fatigue. You may be surprised to hear about this. You might think, well, how could someone with hyperthyroidism actually have fatigue? Well, when someone experiences hyperthyroidism, initially they do have a lot of energy. Eventually, the body starts to break down because we're not meant to have that much thyroid hormone. You know, our body shouldn't be producing that much. So it's difficult on the body. How about you? Have you been diagnosed with hyperthyroidism? What kind of symptoms did you experience? And how have you been feeling since you've received treatment? Let me know in the comments below. I'd like to hear about your experience. Okay, so let's talk about some of the causes. Let's see. The most common one is Graves' disease, which is an autoimmune disease. It's most commonly diagnosed with women. It is hereditary, so if you have a family member who's been diagnosed, you may be at greater risk of developing Graves' disease. However, there was one study that showed that smokers have higher levels of thyroid hormones than non-smokers. So if you're a smoker, this could also increase your likelihood of being diagnosed with Graves' disease. Another thing that can cause hyperthyroidism is thyroid nodules or some kind of growth on the gland. And some people get thyroiditis, which is an inflammation of the gland. Sometimes it's just a temporary immune system problem, or it could be a result of a viral infection. There's also postpartum thyroiditis, which can happen within a year after someone has a baby. Now, the thyroid may be unable to recover from thyroiditis. It actually could lead to hypothyroidism. So it's very important if you've had thyroiditis that you do keep in touch with your physician and keep a check on those levels. Now, another thing that can cause hyperthyroidism is if someone consumes excess iodine, and that could happen by things that they have in their diet or even certain medications. Now, before we move on, I'd like to remind you to please like and subscribe if you're enjoying today's video, and if you'd like YouTube to notify you when my next video is coming out. I'd also like to remind you to always open up the description box below, because there may be some links there that can provide more helpful information for you. Now, in order to get diagnosed with hyperthyroidism, the doctor would have to take a look at your medical history, do a physical exam, and he would order blood tests. Now, before taking the blood test, your doctor may have you stop taking biotin, if that's something you normally take. You have to stop taking it 3 to 5 days before the test, just to avoid a false result. Now, depending on the results of the blood tests, the doctor also may send you for some imaging tests. Now, the treatment that will be recommended will depend on what caused your hyperthyroidism. It may depend on your age and some other factors, but the doctor may recommend anti-thyroid medication, perhaps radioactive iodine, Sometimes it's recommended to have surgery to remove all or part of the thyroid gland. They also use beta blockers sometimes to help manage symptoms. And then, of course, there are some cases where the symptoms will improve without medication or treatment. Now, sometimes with young people, at first, it may be mistaken as nervousness due to stress. And sometimes their symptoms can come on abruptly. With older adults, it may be actually harder to notice the symptoms. But if you do have concerning symptoms that aren't going away, you definitely don't want to leave this condition untreated, because it could lead to atrial fibrillation, stroke, congestive heart failure, and even osteoporosis. So you may want to schedule an appointment with your doctor to get a diagnosis, or if you wanted to start with, just to get a broad picture of how your thyroid is performing, you can get a home thyroid test and see what those results would be. But the good news is, if you do have hyperthyroidism, it is manageable and treatable, and there are many people who get back to feeling perfectly healthy once they've received the appropriate treatment. Well, I hope you've enjoyed today's video. I hope to see you in the next video, where we'll discuss another way we can improve our health.